Thank you for the nice introduction. And yeah, this is joint work with my PhD supervisor, Gabriele Kern-Isberner. So let's start with the general introduction on belief merging. So assume you have information coming from different contexts, and there's actually no precedence between the different information sources. And this information can be conflicting or something. And now the goal is, or the goal of belief merging in general is to get like a consistent set of beliefs out of this different information. There have been introduced a variety of merging operators in the past, and a logical characterization of propositional merging operators was given by Sebastian and Ramon Pino Perez, who are probably also here today. And yeah, so the thing that is new about our work is that we do not look at propositional beliefs, but we take conditional beliefs into account. And yeah, so I want to start with an example. So let's say you want to speculate on the stock market, and there are three financial experts, and you ask them for their instruction for action in the event of a stock bubble. So all of these experts give different instructions for actions in the form of conditional rules. So for example, the first one says, the first one states that stock bubbles lead to crashes, and if there is a bubble, then you should hold your shares. But for example, for a crash in general, you should actually sell your shares, for example. The second one agrees on the fact that bubbles lead to crashes, but says that crashes induced by bubbles should respond to that by holding your shares. And the third one shares some opinion with the other one, but has a different opinion here in that case, for example. So we can take all of these conditional belief bases here denoted as delta 1 to delta 3 and write them in a set of conditional belief bases C, which we will call a conditional profile here. And this conditional profile, so the conditionals within C here are all together an inconsistent set of conditionals, which we denote here as the union of C, a notion that we will use more often, which we call union profile. So all you know is that these experts are actually equally reliable. So what should we do now with our shares in the case of a stock bubble? Yes, and to give a quick overview of the talk, of course, I will start with some formal preliminaries, but then I will discuss three different ways of merging these conditional beliefs. And the first one is a pretty straightforward one based on syntax, and the other one takes into account the ranking for the epistemic states underlying these conditional beliefs, and therefore lead to two different ways of merging, which will be based on more on the semantic side. So first of all, the formal preliminaries. So conditionals, we will use conditionals in the standard way, stating that we have a premise here and a conclusion saying that if A holds, then B should follow plausibly. And the big difference here to propositional information is that conditional information is actually based as on three valued logical entities, which can be evaluated on possible worlds. So a possible world can verify a conditional, it can falsify a conditional, or behave neutral towards conditional information. And as a representation for epistemic states, here we will use in this paper, we used in the paper, ranking functions, are also called ordinal conditional functions, and these are defined by Spohn in the usual way, assigning implausibility ranks to sets of to possible words from omega. Conditionals and ranking function are strongly connected. So first of all, we will give an acceptance notion of conditionals by ranking functions. Ranking function accept the conditional if the verification of the conditional is strictly more plausible than its falsification. And ranking function accepts a set of conditionals delta if it accepts all of the conditionals within delta. These kind of ranking functions that accept a set of conditionals delta are called admissible with respect to delta. And As I said before, conditional set of conditionals and ranking functions are closely connected. And this is reflected here in this statement, because a conditional set, a set of conditionals is actually consistent if and only if there exists a ranking function that models this set of conditionals. And some basic notation for conditional merging, as I mentioned before, a conditional profile, so a set of conditional belief bases will be denoted as C. And we want each of the conditional sets here to be non-empty and actually also to be consistent. We denote the union C here as we denote the union of all the conditional belief bases in C as a union profile. And the same in the same manner, we define the intersection C as the intersection of the conditional belief bases in C. C here, so our conditional profile is consistent if and only if this union profile here is consistent. So now let's move to conditional merging operators. This is a very general definition of conditional merging operators. So conditional merging operators in our framework define a mapping from conditional belief profiles to a set gamma of C. So we get this, we get a set of conditionals here, which we denote gamma of C. And this shall be a consistent set of conditionals. And what we also want is that this gamma C is a subbase, is a subset of the union profile of C. So what we actually do here is we do not get kind of new conditional information, but we just take into account conditional information that was already present in our conditional profile, which actually puts our conditional merging operators more in the vicinity of like selection operators. But yeah, this is a choice that we made here. Because this is a choice, we defined this, this property of gamma C to be a subset of union C as a postulate CM star, and also the consistency of delta C, which is already inherent in our definition of conditional merging operators, appears here as a postulate for conditional merging operators. So these are some postulates for conditional merging operators. Of course, there can be like a lot more that you can think of, but these were the ones that we chose. And CM1 states, for example, that all of the conditional information in our conditional profile, if this is satisfiable, then the result of the merging should not change anything. So we want to accept all of our conditionals in the union profile. CM2, so conditional merging postulate 2, demands irrelevance of syntax. And the third one states that if there is a conditional information which is part of all of the conditional belief bases in C, so actually that's an information all of the agents in C can agree on, then this should also be included in our merging result. So this was very basic, and now we start with our first approach of merging. This is a pretty straightforward approach, which is actually based on a partial meet strategy. And that's why we call them partial meet conditional merging operators. And yes, partial meet is a strategy which is known from belief change, especially with partial meet contractions. And we did it in a pretty similar manner here, because what we started with is that we have to choose maximal consistent sets of our conditional profile. So maximally consistent in terms of set inclusion, where the sets, the maximally consistent sets M shall be shall all include the intersection C and shall not shall all be subsets of our union profile. So the set of all maximal consistent sets is denoted here as MC. And what we also need is a selection function that selects some of the maximally consistent sets from MC. Via this selection function, we are now able to define a partial meet conditional merging operator by taking the intersection of all of the selected maximally consistent sets from MC. And In this way, we can define a conditional merging operator that actually satisfies all of our postulates that we mentioned before. Yes, and I want to give an example for this. So again, we have our three financial experts. And as I mentioned before, here's there appears some inconsistency when we join these three sets. And therefore, we can choose different maximally consistent sets. And what we get here are three different maximally consistent sets, M1, 2, M3. And now we can apply the partial meet conditional merging operator with different selection functions. For example, what we could do is employ some kind of a full meet strategy with all of our maximally consistent sets, or a maxi choice strategy with just one, or for example, pick just two of them. And what we get is we get different merging results here depicted here in these sets. Yeah, what we've seen here is that we get a suitable merging operator, but we do not really have any guidance on which of these selection functions to choose. And that's why we thought it could be a fruitful approach to not only take into account the conditional belief basis in C, but also give them some kind of semantic via taking into account the epistemic states underlying these conditional beliefs. And that's why that's how we came up with two different merging approaches here, which we'll discuss now. So first of all, again, conditionals and epistemic states, as I mentioned before, these are closely intertwined, and we will call this a bidirectional translation, because as I mentioned, conditional belief bases are consistent if they have a ranking model. And also the other way around, if we have a ranking function, we can define a set of conditional via taking all of the conditionals that are via including all of the conditionals that are satisfied by kappa into a set delta kappa. And what we now did for our merging purposes, we assume that for the conditional belief profile, we always have some kind of ranking profile, which we denoted here as E, where we assume that the epistemic states underlying these conditional beliefs are in some way given. So the only thing we demand here from our ranking profile is that these ranking functions kappa E are delta E admissible, so admissible to the corresponding set of conditional beliefs. Yes, and what we also need is some kind of semantic characterization of conditional merging operators. This is also kind of similar to syncretic assignments for propositional merging operators. So coalescent assignment here are assignments that map a conditional belief profile to a ranking function kappa C. And via this kappa C, we are able to define conditional merging operators. What we first did is define some postulates for the coalescent assignment. And these are kind of similar to the postulates for conditional merging operators that we've seen before. So as you can see, CA1 actually corresponds to CM2, as it says that if the conditional information in C is satisfiable, then also our coalescent assignment should satisfy all of the conditional information in C. CA2 corresponds to irrelevance of syntax, and CA3 states again that if there is conditional information that all of the agents agree on, then also our coalescent assignment should satisfy this. So what we did now to get a conditional merging operator is that we lifted the coalescent assignment to a conditional belief base via taking into account only the conditionals in the union profile. And then we determined this merging result as the set of conditional beliefs of conditionals that are satisfied by our coalescent assignment. So this is here. And yes, as I mentioned before, these postulates correspond to the postulates for conditional belief merging, and the CM star and CM zero postulate is always satisfied by a coalescent assignment because we defined it as a ranking function. So what the way that we are taking now is that we go from conditional belief profiles to a merging result via ranking profiles and coalescent assignment. And this step here is a pretty crucial step, which we will discuss now. So let's assume we have a ranking profile, and what we want to determine now is a ranking function. And the way to do this is to take into to kind of merge the information in the or combine the information in the ranking profile using combination operators. These combination operators were firstly introduced by Meliha, and we adapted them for our purposes of merging ranking functions. There are also some postulates for combination operators for ranking functions, but I didn't wanted to bore you too much with too many postulates. So the thing that I want to show here is that there are combination operators which you can define in a pretty straightforward way, for example, via taking the minimal ranks of worlds of ranking functions in the ranking profile, or the maximum, or for example, sum up all of the ranks in the ranking profile corresponding to a possible word omega. And via the mapping from conditional profiles to ranking profiles, these combination operators define coalescent assignments, and these coalescent assignments satisfy our postulate CA2. So, and using this mapping, we can define conditional merging operators via these combination operators via the lifting that we've seen here before. So we have our combination operators, and then take the conditionals that are satisfied by these combination operators as the result of the merging. And this merging operator satisfies CM star, CM zero, and CM two. So what we see here, some of the postulates are missing, and we will deal with this later. But first, I want to give an example. Again, we are stuck. We are still stuck with our three financial experts, and here we have the conditional, the ranking profile, ranking functions underlying these conditional beliefs, and define the combination operators here on the right side of the table. And what we get is different merging results here. For example, for the last one, for the sum, actually none of the conditionals in C are satisfied. So as we can see here, there's still some work left to do. And also CM1 and CM3 do not hold. And we discovered that this is actually due to the fact that combination of ranking functions neglects conditional, so the logical dependencies between conditionals across C. So we have delta admissible ranking functions here. So for each the conditional belief-based conditional dependencies are respected, but if they are, but for the logical dependencies that appear for conditionals across C, so from different belief conditional belief bases, we do not have a mechanism to respect them. And so what we did now, we refined our combination operators actually. And the way that we refined it is that actually we looked at a mechanism, like we were looking for something to monitor conditional interactions while combining these ranking functions. And conditional interactions can be monitored via order tolerance partitions, actually, which are defined by Perl. But these are only exist for consistent sets of conditionals. And what I said before, we are also dealing with inconsistent set of conditionals if we look at the union of all of the conditionals in our belief profiles. So we defined a paraconsistent partition that is defined in the usual way. So we start with our algorithm to define tolerance partition, but we also define a conflicting subbase which collects all of the conditionals that are not tolerated from the rest of the conditionals that is already in our partition. And using this paraconsistent partition, we define an ordered paraconsistent partition of our set of possible words omega. We need this set. This partition of omega Because what we need when we combine our ranking function is that we need some kind of layers in our possible worlds. And these layered in our ordered paraconsistent partition of omega correspond to the layers of this paraconsistent partition of delta, because we take into account in some omega k, all of the worlds that do not falsify any conditionals from omega k and all of from delta k and all of the layers of the tolerance partition above. Yes, and this omega bar collects kind of the rest. So this is a really technical result here, but what we get is this layering of omega, which we see here in this example. So this is, here we have a rather small partition with this C0, and the rest of the conditionals are written into our paraconsistent, into our conflicting subbase. But what we see here is that we can now layer our set of possible worlds. Yes, and using this paraconsistent partition of omega, we can define combination operators that respect conditional dependencies. And the crucial point is, or the crucial difference between the combination operators from before, is that we add here some kind of penalty term or impact factor that leads to a separation of these layers. And what this zeta k or zeta bar here for the last layer does is that it allows us to separate omegas from different layers of omega k. So this result here holds for combination operators with respect to conditional dependencies. An omega from a layer from omega k is always strictly more plausible than an omega tilde from an omega in a layer above. So from some possible world in a layer above. Yes, and using these combination operators with respect to conditional dependencies, we can define results of coalescent assignment actually in the same way as before. And now we get that if there that we also satisfy CA1. So we get we get a coalescent assignment that respects conditional dependencies across C better than before. So and we define our conditional merging operator here in the same way as before, using the lifting. And this conditional merging operator satisfies CM star and CM 0 to 2 with the corresponding combination operators. And we see here our result, and what is different than the result before is that we add our conditional from the lowermost layer of the partition to all of the merging results here. Okay, yes, and this is where I conclude my talk. As we've seen, this logical structure of conditional imposes a lot of challenges on the merging operator, and we were not able to solve all of them, but I think this is a pretty good overview of what kind of challenges we are facing here. And as I said before, we have we defined these three ways of merging conditional belief bases. One of them is a straightforward approach, and the other one takes into account the epistemic states of agents in order to respect conditional interactions also across conditional belief bases. Okay, and thank you for your attention.